Through there, there's a cow. He walked, that's the cow that greeted me at the other end of the field, right? And I was walking up high on a path, but there's some workmen there. That cow made a determined effort, really striding out to get back across the field to where those met workmen were. Because there are cows in that field. The bull has hardly moved. But it could be that the cow is waiting for water to fill that stream up. You know, you must get thirsty. I mean, I don't know if there was a drinking vessel in the field there. But it was the way it moved. It left, none of the other herd did anything. But that cow, still watching them. He's watching them with intent. It's a female one. It's really, really watching those men. They're waterboard men. They're obviously measuring. They've got all their laptops and all that there. And one of them's got like long waterproof trousers on that fishermen wear. I've decided to come out here, even though I'm heading over there eventually. I think, well, I've come this far. I just will just do the little walk just to get to this end of the breach. Just as well. And it could be that I can walk round to Steart from here because this is the summer only walk. Apparently this isn't accessible in the winter. And I tell you what, it is getting warm now. I've drunk one bottle of water. I've still got my fruit juice, which is only a small bottle, about 250 mils, and a big bottle of water. I'm going to need that, but I might be able to top up somewhere yet when I get in the village if I need to. I've got oranges. I've got two oranges. I've ate me pie. I've ate me cheese and tomatoes. I've ate me Kit Kat. There's a lot of little seats where you can... Yeah, I just thought I'd just well come up here. There it is. That's what I'm heading for there. I'm going to turn off for a minute. So I expect I'll have to put the charger on soon. Don't want to run out completely before I get to the hide. Right, look what I can see. There's Steart hide there. That's what I'm aiming for, and it's right in line for where I'm going to walk now along the track there. There's a track here, I think. God, look at this, beautiful. The blue sky's getting blue again. So I've just been at this, yeah, it seems to be filling up with a bit of water. They say it's good to see it when it's filling up. So over there last week, I was on the other side of the breach. The breach obviously means a gap in the bank. And I was over there. I was over there by that fence there, looking over here. There's the, in the distance there, you can see the barrage balloon hanger there, showing really well. So I'd done that. So I've done a big loop, but you can't get across this bit. Oh, look at that, all buttercups. Isn't it beautiful? Look, everyone, it's absolutely beautiful, isn't it? And they've provided seats so you can sit and have a drink, have a rest, because they, like me, I've walked a long way. And now I'm hoping I can get to that hide. It doesn't tell me I can. I'm hoping there ain't another bloody breach, if you know what I mean. I'm hoping I can get the hide this way. This is the winter route, they said. Looks like someone's been along and cut the grass for me. Avoid dangerous mud and creeks. Route closed 1st of October to the 31st of March to avoid disturbance to feeding and roosting birds. And this is called the England Coast Path National Trail. And what a beautiful, wow, beautiful. I've just come up that track there, look. I've been on a massive walk. There's Hinkley Point right in the distance. You've got all this beautifulness of spring, everything bursting and emerging. We've got Burnham-on-Sea over there. We've got Brent Knoll. Right over there in front of me, we've got West Huntsville Church that I go to a lot. I don't go to the church to pray. I go there to park and then go for a walk on that side of the river. There's West Huntsville Church, look. And I usually walk on that side of the river, but it's known to have cows, a lot of cows. And I'm going to follow this track. That's plan A, towards the hide. The hide is straight in front of me. I've been in it before. Straight ahead, there it is. What a beautiful view as well for a photograph. Look. Beautiful. Yeah, if I'd gone the other way, I think you have to walk along the road. I might come back that way, you see. Do a circular. I like doing circulars. Hi, Burnham-on-Sea. I just zoom into Burnham. I can see the smallest pier in the country. Burnham-on-Sea there, and the Church of St. Andrews. There's the small pier. There's the church, and Burnham-on-Sea there. And behind, we've got the Mendip Hills, of course. This will be my part two of this walk. The other side of the breach, I'll call it. The other side of the breach. Right, over and out, everyone.